Hey everyone, hope you're having an amazing day. It's Mark Weens, I'm in Lima, Peru, and today we are going to Chorrillos. We're in Chorrillos, which is a district of Lima known for its fishing community. And so today we're going on a seafood Peruvian tour. We're gonna walk around Chorrillos. We're starting at the fish market. We're gonna see the boats. We're gonna hopefully meet some of the fishermen and go on a boat ride. And then afterwards, we'll be going to a local family home in Chorrillos, learning about the history, and they will prepare a Peruvian seafood meal for us.
Are they pelicans?
Chorrillos is kind of on a little peninsula. It's not really a peninsula, but a little outcropping of land. So you have a view of the bay, of the water, of Lima on the cliff.
They get fed well around here.
This guy's huge.
Hey guy.
We're beginning at the artisanal Mercado Pescado, the fish market. This is where they have a fish market. They're selling seafood. This is the fresh catch of the day from the boats. But this is also where fishermen depart, where fishermen leave. The boats are docked here. Alfredo was explaining to us that this is an association. So the fishermen gather together and have created this market to benefit the entire community of Chorrillos.
Which one is the best for city? Is it the sole?
For ceviche, actually, or you can try anything as long as it's very fresh.
Okay, cool.
But many people prefer the sole.
The sole? Yeah.
The market is fantastic. Just kind of low-key, relaxed, fresh seafood. You can feel that it's like community-driven.
So you can see there the name Jose Silverio Olaya, that is the name of this association, and it's also the name of one of the most important heroes here in Peru. It's considered a hero because he fought for Peru during the independence war of Peru. He used to take letters from this pier to the main port of El Callao. It's like 15, 17 kilometers. Mm-hmm. Swimming. Wow. ¿Puede darnos uno?
Gracias.
Bueno, gracias.
Just came around offering leche de tigre, which is it's like the dressing, the milk of the tiger, but the dressing of the ceviche, which is a combination. It can be a combination of things. It can be especially lime juice, especially garlic, sometimes other spices, but also mixing with the fish, with the juices, the seafood juices.
Oh man.
Oh, that's pretty.
Maybe it's not the absolute best ceviche you'll have, but that's delicious. And I really do wanna drink it. Oh, that's so good. It's really like oniony, garlicky.
Wow.
That's delicious. The juice is good.
Oh yeah, there's like cabbage.
This really is all about the leche de tigre though. That's your beverage of choice. From here, we're gonna walk out towards the pier, and Alfredo has arranged for us to take a boat. I love this area already because of the views, and you see the fishing boats, but then across the water and above the cliff, you can see the skyline of Lima. I think that's especially like Barranco and Miraflores just rising off the water, off the cliff. We are gonna take a quick little boat ride to see the ocean, see the views. It's wonderful. And the weather today, it was kind of cloudy in the morning, but now it's clearing up. The sun is shining. It's a great day. It's good to get out into the ocean just for a little bit of a different perspective. But something I want to share is that Peru is rich in food, but rich in seafood, especially because of the cold water currents off the coast of Peru. And so that's what makes the water so rich, so fertile, so abundant with seafood. These massive pelican birds, they fly pretty gracefully. ride was great. We're now walking back to the pier, and then we're gonna walk into the village, into the community of Chorrillos. This is the old part of Chorrillos, the community of Chorrillos, and this is where we're gonna walk into the community. We're gonna see, visit one of the main men who makes boats, makes the boats, all of the boats, and also go to the family who's gonna cook us lunch today.
Hola.
Hola. His family is the same family we're gonna visit.
Oh, okay.
They're relatives.
Okay.
This family has been living here in Chorrillos for many generations. This is the adobe.
Ah, still made from adobe.
Yeah.
Stepping down another side street here, already you can see the frame of a boat, the skeleton of a boat here. We must be getting close to where he is making the boats. Mucho gusto, mucho gusto. Families, many of the people in this area revolve around the sea and revolve around fishing. It's a fishing community.
The man, the person who's building. ¿Se puede presentar usted, por favor, con el señor?
Sí.
Su nombre.
Yeah, mi nombre es Wilfredo.
His name is Wilfredo.
Wilfredo, okay.
My name. My
mucho
name.
Gusto, mucho gusto.
Wilfredo Aguilar.
And he's the main guy who makes the boats.
He's the owner of
for
this,
all of Chorrillos.
He makes the boats for all
cool.
Chorrillos. He's the only
very
one.
Cool.
There's no competition for
very
him.
Very good.
Cool.
No, we can get inside.
Okay, it's everything still made by hand. It's an art, it's a skill, it's very cool to be able to see this. And this is right, still right within Lima.
Estos botes son para pesca.
These boats are for
sí.
fishing.
Este es el inicio. Este es el inicio y este ya está terminado.
These are all fishing boats rather than transport boats, and it takes at least 1 month per boat. He said one of these boats can handle 2 tons of fish.
¿Qué tiene? Este es el horno.
They heat it with fire, and then like the steam rises, there's water. They put the wood inside of a pipe so that it heats, it cooks, and then they bend it on
this
sawhorse.
Yeah.
Very cool. Very fascinating to see them at work, to learn about the shipbuilding, boat building, and how it's been in his family. His father, his grandfather were all carpenters, were all making boats. Okay, cool. Gracias.
Go!
Gracias.
Gracias. Sí, sí. Mucho gusto.
Tú
la casa.
Mucho gusto.
Tú la casa.
And we're moving more into the community, up a flight of stairs to the family, Criolla family, who is going to cook for us, who we're going to visit. Up the stairs, down an alley.
In Peru, we have this Creole family, Creole culture, that is a fusion of Spanish traditions, indigenous traditions, Afro Peruvian traditions, and all of them blended in something that we call Creole. And so they have interesting activities like what we are going to see right now with the fighting cocks.
So if you say like a Peruvian Creole, it's really a combination of...
Right now it's a combination of the
people from that have influenced
exactly.
Peru.
Mm-hmm. And most cool. of them live in the coast.
Okay.
In the coast of Peru.
Okay. Cool.
Okay. Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Hola.
Bienvenido.
Él es el...
Gracias.
Sí, bueno, hay dos acá que hacen bien.
Adelante, adelante.
Micah, look at the rooster.
Que vengan todos, ¿eh?
They raise a lot of fighting roosters here. It's been part of the culture, and so he's just gonna show us some of the roosters, and the beautiful roosters that they raise here.
When the Spanish arrived here, they brought the roosters. And there are different breeds, you know, from Spain, from Asia, also from North America, and here in Peru there are lots of breeds from everywhere in the world.
Diles que estos lomos que tiene acá le sale del entrenamiento de la arena.
Los lomos.
La espalda.
You can see the muscles here.
Que los toque. De lo que corre en la arena.
because he's exercising all the time. He's running.
Como si fuera un gimnasio.
Because this is like a gym.
Sí. Y en la casa entre los 400 gallos, todos son salvajes, pican, atacan. Este es un gallo manso.
And he said out of 400 roosters that he has, this one is the only really friendly rooster, but you could feel the muscles, you could see that beak, the head, the feathers. It's really a beautiful, gorgeous, gorgeous rooster. It's just like a maze that just winds its way up. Oh, and we made it to the next road up here. Wow, the view of Lima from above here.
Grandmother of this family is an excellent cook.
Okay.
But she's already too old. But her sons are really excellent, and they had the idea to open this very small restaurant on the top of the house.
That's awesome. So this is their restaurant too?
Yeah, it's all part of the
cool
house.
Place.
This is actually where we're gonna eat. This is an amazing location. It's like kind of like a lean-to shelter over the chicken pens, overlooking the Chorrillos, overlooking Lima.
Yeah,
oh. They taste like powdered milk on the inside. Amazing.
Is that really?
Is that pisco?
Sí,
sí, sí. Es el licor tradicional de acá, a base de uva. A ver, ya. Estos son conchas de abanico. Conchas de abanico. Entonces, acá tenemos una variedad de mariscos que vienen a ser langostinos, el caracol y tenemos calamar también acá. Calamares. Y esto es un buen filete de
lenguado.
Pescado blanco, lenguado.
Getting ready to make the ceviche, especially with the scallops, with the is it called lenguado? Lengualo, which is the Peruvian soul fish, which is the one-eyed flounder. It's a type of flounder, I believe, and then also some of the squid and shrimp.
Estos son los ingredientes en los cuales nosotros estamos basados a cocinar, ¿no? Claro. Y mira, esto es una crema de ají amarillo. Esto no pica. Sí, ya le he quitado el ají, ya le he quitado el picor para que tenga aroma y sabor.
¿Sí? It's like sweet.
Oh, gracias, gracias, muchas gracias. Thank you, thank you. Empezamos acá. Acá el ceviche mixto.
Sí.
Vamos a picar un poco más que me quedo chico, ¿eh? Claro, con lenguado. A ver, ají amarillo. Sí. Ají amarillo. Rocoto molido. Rocoto.
Rocoto.
Ajos. Ajo molido. Ají limo. Excelente. Esto es la base del ceviche.
Picante.
Todo esto va a salir. Si comen picante ustedes. Entonces pasamos a hacerle el ceviche mixto. Mil limones. Miren, observen. Limones. Excelente limón, traído de Chulucana, del norte de Perú.
First, he took the mix of seafood, the squid, the octopus, the shrimp, and the fish. He put it all into a mixing bowl. Then he added some of the rocoto, which is a type of chili pureed. Then some of the aji pureed chili. He squeezed in about 5 limes into one portion.
¿Sí? ¿Cómo mover? Wow. ¿Sientes? ¿Hueles?
Sí, claro que sí.
Aroma, sabor. Marcos, vas a tener el privilegio de probar un buen ceviche.
It smells unbelievable.
Okay, entonces, yo quisiera saber si tú pudieras probarle. A ver.
Wow.
¿Cuál es su nombre?
Oh, wow. Timor, you gotta try that, man. Oh, el ajo.
Todo, ajo, cebolla, rocoto,
wow.
Aquí.
Sí.
Poderoso, ¿sí o no, Marco? Mi amigo Marco, un saludo muy grande para mi amigo Marco. De acá desde Chorrillos, Perú, Luis Alberto Casas Javero.
Muchas gracias.
De nada.
Buenísima.
Ya, entonces vamos a terminar por servirle, ¿sí?
You can see the liquid turn to like milkiness from that fish.
O sea, no, para usted, amigo Marco, una picada, ¿sí? Entonces vamos a proceder ahora sí nuestro ceviche de pescado. Vamos a echarle su sal, secretos del Perú, su ajo. buen ajo, muy rico.
The garlic in there is
standard. Rocoto. Solo rocoto, cilantro o culantro como le decimos nosotros, ¿sí?
One of the main ingredients that he adds, which is different from other versions of ceviche that I've had, is ajo, like paste, garlic paste, and you immediately taste that when he you take your first bite, and even the aroma, there's so much garlic in it.
Y aquí limo. Okay. Entonces vamos a proceder a exprimirle los limones. Qué re chocolateamos, ¿sí? ¡Chao, Fernando! Marco.
Sí.
Ceviche de pescado a base de rocoto y ají limo. Totalmente natural. Ustedes los ingredientes les dijeron, los han visto, sal, ajo, rocoto, ají limbo, cebolla y limón. Ok, Marco, listo. A ver, okay. ¿Listo para probar?
Listo, 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 listo para probar.
Julio.
Oh, wow. Blown away. Good. This
una
is the
más,
man.
Más,
he
más,
is no. The ceviche man.
Your name is the man. A ver,
Timor.
Compañero. A ver. ¿Sí? ¿Ya estamos? ¿Te firmas o no?
Sí, sí, vamos a ver. Tengo. Me gusta mucho el toque de ajo. No se acostumbra a eso.
Es increíble, ¿no? Mm. El ajo es la base nuestra, la base chorriana, es la base de acá, que lo hemos descubierto, en mis manos.
Gorgeous ceviches, and some of the more vibrant, some of the more garlicky, some of the more like colorful ceviches that I've seen. Okay, I'm gonna dig into this, the shrimp, the squid, the fish that is in here. And that dressing though, the onions, like just this one, that dressing is just unbelievable. You can smell the lime juice, that leche de tigre.
That smells so
it
good.
Looks like orange juice because of that yellow chili.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
The juice.
That juice.
Mm. One thing I forgot to, you gotta do is, let's do a spoon and put some cancha.
Oh yeah, okay.
You need to have the crunchy part.
Good idea. Try that scallop with some of the corn.
Hola, amigos. Ooh. Tiradito.
Oh, he made the tiradito.
Este es nuestro tiradito de pescado a base de ají amarillo con un sabor muy, muy bueno que solo vas a encontrar acá de nuevo.
Buen provecho.
Okay, so another dish that I've been waiting to try is called tiradito. Kind of like ceviche, but different at the same time. It does have Japanese influence, so the fish is sliced Japanese sashimi style. The main difference is that it's the ají amarillo paste, just that yellow chili paste. And you can see it's like pure yellow. Then he said there's some lime juice in there, and that's mostly it with some cilantro, and then the fish is just like soaking in that marinade, in that puree of ají amarillo. It's oh, thank you. A choclo on top. Okay, that's okay. I got it. Look at the color of that. Wow. Stunning.
Yes.
Is there milk in that?
There is a little bit of milk.
Maybe a little milk, okay.
A little bit of acetate of oil to make the paste, to make it nice and creamy. There's not as much lemon as in the ceviche.
You're right.
So much more.
Not quite as salty.
Mm-hmm.
Almost has like a cheesy taste to it.
Yeah.
Wow.
This is really good.
And the garlic.
Yes.
And that's specifically Luis Casa, his signature garlic, because you don't find that much garlic in other places as much. Wow, that's stunning.
That's stunning, exactly.
That wow. Is stunning, huh? And then next place of ceviche, this is the Peruvian sole ceviche. But again, like, it's red, like the color of watermelon because of all the rocoto chili in there that he used to paste. And then tons of garlic paste in there as well. Let's try this one.
Yes, I do. This time I want you to take the choclo and bite it like this.
Okay, after, yes. Like you take a bite of ceviche
bite
and then eat some of the choclo.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. With the onions, with the cilantro on top. And also this one, he did sort of slice the fish as well, rather than cube it.
I like it sliced like this.
If you slice, you kind of maximize the flavor that can get into it, right? Piece of the choclo already.
Garlic that just shines in there.
Nice and fresh.
And then chase it with the corn. Oh, like the silkiness of that corn.
Milky.
Mm-hmm.
It reduces some, no, a little bit of the lime and the power of the rocoto. And when you taste everything a little bit all together, I think you die and went to heaven, seriously.
Mm. Yes, that is right.
Let me add a few chilies here.
And then you're gonna wanna taste every bite with that leche de tigre. You can just rejuice in your mouth. The rejuicing of ceviche is taken to another level.
Wow.
That is.
That's all. Oh, yes. Nice, nice move.
Don't ever forget the cancha.
How's the food, Alfredo?
That's awesome. I really love it. I love Luis, really excellent chef.
Of course, the food is insanely tasty, but when combined with this environment, oh man, that's a place you don't want to miss.
The way he cuts it is amazing.
Combinación.
I like that one.
That chef, maga.
That's the fun thing.
Yeah,
fun
exactly.
And with the sweet potato.
Ya, ahora sí. Ok, para hacerle la demostración de un sudado de lenguado, ¿sí? Vamos a echarle ajo. Aquí, amarillo. Ok, ají mirasol y pasta de ají amarillo.
Okay. What is the difference?
La diferencia...
Oh, the dry and the...
Ají mirasol es seco.
Claro, el ají mirasol es seco y el ají amarillo es fresco. Echamos una salsa base. Salsa, nosotros le llamamos salsa madre acá. Sí, esto tiene tomates. Tiene otra especie de ají también que es ají mirasol. Tiene tomate, cebolla, poquito de sal. Volteamos el pescado siempre. Sí. Echarle para que salga bien. ¿Qué? ¿Qué? A meter un poco de caldo de pescado.
No.
Fondo de pescado, ¿sí? Esta yuca viene de la selva del Perú. Hecha, es una raíz, pero contiene mucho almidón. Este caldo que tiene acá va a tomar un espesor único.
He first took some onions, simmered them in some oil. Then he took two different pastes, the ají amarillo, the dry of that chili paste, and then the fresh of that chili paste, pureed. Put that into the sauce, and then some of the, like a tomato paste with some garlic. Then he added in the fish bones, which he seasoned with salt and pepper. And then finally he added in the, some of the caldo de pescado, which is the fish stock. And then finally some pieces of yuca, which is cassava.
Cebolla.
Oh my God. Qué rico.
Marco.
Super rico.
Gracias.
De nada, Marco.
Taste test.
Qué rico.
You feel that the texture of the yuca?
Yeah, see, it slightly
it
gummy.
Yeah, it makes it
very, very, very slightly. And like the
Marco,
fish bones.
¿Qué tal?
Muy rico.
De nada, de nada, de nada.
Wow.
Muchas gracias.
Eso para que mi amigo Marco y mi amigo
Sí, muchas gracias.
Vuelvan
muchas gracias.
De nuevo acá a Perú.
He just doesn't stop adding in ingredients.
Esto lo voy a servir con todo. Amigos. Terminamos acá con esto de acá. ¿Sí? Esto es el ají amarillo.
Yes.
Ají amarillo.
Ají amarillo.
Precioso, aromático, sabroso, oriundo del Perú, que en ninguna otra parte se encuentra del
mucha
mundo. Solo aquí en el Perú. Solo en el Perú.
Most of the dishes that he made right now would not be possible without the ají amarillo. What a dish.
Por favor.
Okay. It is time for this main dish, and this is his passion, his love for the cooking, and his like expertise. My favorite move is his lime move, where he puts it into a squeezer and just like smashes it mid-air.
Oh, where? Look at that.
Oh. Bring me your plate, I'll give you a whole piece of fish. I just cannot believe Peruvian juices, Peruvian food juices. They're like just unbelievable. I'll definitely be rejuicing throughout this plate. The onions, the, wow. What's outstanding about this is just its pureness, its freshness, and just like, it's just good. So good. Mm-hmm.
What's funny is that this dish, I love it, but I always forget about it. There's so many choices in Peru, but here's like, it's been so long I haven't had this, cool. And it's so easy to make in your house too.
This is a great way to use all the fish too and not throw away any of those bones.
Want some rice?
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Like right inside the center there. A little bit of rice to chop it up. Cool, that's good. Thank you. And then also come and eat it with rice, which is perfect.
It's a jaw of a donkey. It's a donkey's jaw. The teeth that make the sound. There's no meat inside anymore, like muscle, so
yeah.
They are like this.
Okay, mi hermano, siempre vengan a Perú.
Muchas gracias, muchas gracias. That could be the coolest instrument ever.
This is amazing.
Muchas gracias.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Muchas gracias.
Gracias, gracias también.
So we're just jumping into the van just for a little bit, just to drive up the hill, I believe, to go to one final location. Wow, the breeze, you can see, and we're on like, there's ocean on one side, there's city on the other side. The breeze up here, the statue of Jesus Christ and the coolness, but just like the barren, barren land. Beautiful at the same time. And so right here at the top of the hill, overlooking the ocean, overlooking Lima, this is the perfect place to end this video today. It's been a fantastic day and a learning experience and a totally different, off the beaten path, yet normal life experience in Lima. And I wanna say a huge thank you to Alfredo for being our guide, for bringing us here. This video is not sponsored. I paid for this tour, but it was through Alternative Peru. And they have some very cool off the beaten path tours. I would highly recommend them. I'll have their link in the description box. It was just, overall, just such a fun day. I will have a playlist that you can click in the link in the description box below, including all the Peruvian food food videos. So we've had some incredible food in Peru. So if you haven't already watched all those videos, go check them out below. And I want to say a big thank you for watching this video. Please remember to give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Leave a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. If you're not already subscribed, click the subscribe button and also the little bell icon so that you get notified of the next video that I publish. Thanks again for watching. Just got really, really windy. And I will see you on the next video. Beautiful. Beautiful.